Next up on JimboVision, Arrival. Hello. This week I sat for hours in the darkness watching Arrival, then Commode took a restraining order out, so I went to the cinema for Denis Villeneuve's bold and brand new sci-fi drama thing about what happens when extraterrestrials show up with an important message for humanity, but no translator. Now, anyone who's expecting Klaatu Barradu Niktu hijinks here, or the kind of thrills and spills we got in ID4, is in for a bit of a surprise. This has far more in common with Jodie Foster's Contact, a movie that uses outer space as a means for inner reflection. Arrival stars the very busy Amy Adams, for once not wearing a dress the wrong way around, as Dr. Louise Banks, a linguistic expert haunted by thoughts of her daughter. When 12 alien ships, played here by Brancusi's Bird in Space, appear at locations around the planet, gruff military type Forest Whitaker enlists Banks and scientist Jeremy Renner to decipher their language, which uniquely appears composed of henna tattoos. Meanwhile, just for a change, armed forces worldwide are planning to shoot the visitors up first and ask questions later.
China just threatened to destroy their shell. Whatever they do, France and Korea will follow.
The French there. Must have been quite a policy meeting. Just put us down for whatever China does. Croissant? Anyway, then the fate of all things hangs on one linguist's cunning. Can Amy unlock the ET's ABCs before things get blown to kingdom come? Now, Arrival does feature nods to all the usual alien incursion favourites. The panicked population, the news reports, the scrambled jets, the Nigel Farage sticking the visitors up on posters. But Villeneuve leaves all of that almost entirely in the background. He's far more interested in Dr. Banks, her efforts to communicate with her tentacled friends, and the resulting impact on her own conception of time. These are big and, it turns out, fascinating ideas, but the focus on them is the strength and the weakness of this picture. For everything else here feels a little bit perfunctory. I found myself wondering, why are they here? At least as much about Renner and Whitaker as the aliens. Adam's co-stars very much left sidelined by all the heptapods in the mist stuff. As for the threat of global military meltdown, it never really feels anything but a plot device. Now, against all of that, Arrival is beautifully shot, all dimly lit and washed out colours, so you know it's serious. It also has a powerfully brooding score, a nice pro-unity message, an extremely thought-provoking screenplay, and a fine central performance by Adams. And it's interesting to see a sci-fi film that relies on ideas rather than explosions for its big denouement. Perhaps it's not surprising then that Denis Villeneuve's latest has left critics weak at Denis. For me though, I found it worthy but a little bit short on cinematic wow compared to the innocent wonder of, say, Close Encounters or the wild overambition of Nolan's similarly big concept Interstellar. This was a little bit like the alien spaceship, dark, stylish, but not all that interesting to look at. I'll give Arrival a solid 6.5 out of 10 on JimboVision, but do let me know how wrong I am underneath.